हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप यू ऑल आर वेल बेटा। क्लास 9 ऑन फ्राइडे वी हैव अरेंज अ टेस्ट, क्लास टेस्ट फॉर लाइंस एंड एंगल्स टॉपिक बेटा। नाउ दिस वीडियो लेक्चर इज गोइंग टू बी सोल्व द ऑल द असाइनमेंट प्रॉब्लम्स, बिकॉज इट वॉज क्वेरी फ्रॉम मैनी स्टूडेंट्स दैट लॉट्स ऑफ क्वेश्चन वर देयर विच वर नॉट रिगार्डिंग द एनसीईआरटी क्वेश्चंस। बट बेटा, इफ यू कंसिडर द बेसिक कंसेप्ट इज सेम एज वेल एज दैट वॉज डिस्कस्ड इन एनसीईआरटी। सो डू नॉट वरी, नाउ दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू हैव द सोल्यूशन ऑफ ऑल द क्वेरीज एंड डेफिनेटली यू विल ऑल बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द कंसेप्ट। ओके, सो विदाउट एनी डिले एवरीबडी बी रेडी विद द PDF ऑफ वर्कशीट इन योर हैंड, पेन एंड नोटबुक। एंड वन मोर थिंग बेटा, इफ एनी वन हैज डोंट हैव द PDF of the sheet, I will provide you it in the description. You can download from there. Okay? So everyone, be ready without any delay. Question number one. See, what is question number one? Here is the question. Statement is the complement of an angle is 1/4 of the supplement. Complement of an angle is 1/4 of the supplement of this. See, once you all should know what are complementary angles. See beta, the angles whose sum is 90 degree, the angles whose sum is 90 degree are complementary angles. Let me give you an example. Suppose there is an angle x and y and their sum is 90 degree, then these are complementary angles. And in other words we can say x is complement of y and y is complement of x. You got my point? Why? Because when x is given to y, it gives the sum 90, as well as in the same way when y is given to x, the sum obtained is 90. See, suppose 30 degree is the angle A, then what will be the complement of A will be 60 degree. Why? Because their sum is 90. Got it? In the same way about supplementary angles, if the sum is 180 degree, beta, here please note the point. In complementary angles, as the sum was 90, here in case of supplementary, the sum is 180. Okay, let me give you an example. Suppose one angle is 60 degree, then what will be the supplementary of it will be 120, because their sum is giving us 180 degree. Okay, now about the statement. Suppose beta, there is an angle x. Suppose let the given angle is bx. What we considered, the angle asked in the statement is x. Now what is condition? See, what is the complement of x? Complement of x will be 90 minus x. Yes or no? See beta, when we add 90 minus x to x, what will be the sum? 90. Okay, therefore the complement of x will be 90 minus x. In the same way, what will be the supplement of x? 180 minus x. Yes or no? I think you got my point. Why 180 minus x? Because its sum with x will give you 180. In the same way, its sum with x will give you 90. Okay? Now see, what is the condition? Complement of the angle is 1/4 of the supplement. Okay? See, complement, that is 90 minus x, is equal to what? Equal to 1/4 of its supplement. I think you all got my point. Okay, this was the given condition. Now I think you all are expert in solving the equations. Let me solve it. Here apply the cross multiplication. 4 into 90 minus x is equal to 180 minus x. Yes or no? 4 into 90 minus x is equal to 180 minus x. Now multiply 4 inside. What is this property known as? Distributive property, okay? 4 into 90, 360. 4 into x, minus 4x, because plus minus, product is minus, is equal to 180 minus x. Done. Now see beta, shift the variables one side and keep the constants on other side. Here is minus 4x. Here is minus 4x. Shift x towards left. What it will be? It will be plus x. And see, what is the right hand side? Constant part is 180. And if you shift 360 towards right, it will be minus 360. Yes or no? Done. Now see beta, minus 4 plus x, minus 4 plus x, what it will be? It will be minus 3x. It will be minus 3x. And now see, what is this? What is the difference here? Minus 180. This is minus 180. From here, what will you get? Minus cancels minus, and x is equal to 60 degree. X is equal to 60 degree. Okay, beta. Hence, the required angle, or you can say the asked angle is will be 60 degree. Why 60? Because now you can verify also. See beta, what was the condition? I am writing the condition here. Everyone see? What was the condition? Complement of this. Complement of this is 30 degree. And 1/4 of its supplement. 1/4 of its supplement. What is supplement of 60 degree? 120, and its 1/4 will be 30 degree. Both are same, yes or no? Hence our calculation is right. Done beta? All got my point? Is it clear? If it is not clear to you, just rewind the video and try to understand the concept. Very, very, very simple beta. Complement of angle was 1/4 of supplement. We just made an equation, solved the equation, and find the required angle. Okay, done. You can take the screenshot. Done beta, I think you all have taken the screenshot. Now question number 2. Everybody, till then I am roughing the board. Keep reading the next statement. Statement number 2. See, what is the statement here beta? The question asks is, the angles of a supplementary pair are in the ratio 3:2. Supplementary pair of angles means the angles are giving the sum 180 degree. Angles are giving the sum 180 degree, and the angles are in ratio 3:2. Done beta? Angles are in ratio 3:2. Number 2 question. Okay, see, let common factor be x. Why? Whenever the sum of ratio is there, always remember, ratio is not the exact value. Ratio is not showing the exact value. Why? Because ratios are obtained by cutting some common multiples. Okay, that's why, suppose common factor be x, angles ratio given is 3:2. Therefore beta, first angle will be 3x. Now it you can say this is the value. Okay, second angle will be 2x. Yes or no? First angle is 3x, second is 2x. Now according to condition, what is the condition? These two are forming a pair of supplementary angles. These two are forming a pair of supplementary angles. That is 3x plus 2x 180 degrees. 3x plus 2x, 180 degrees. Now see beta, 5x is equal to 180. 5x is equal to 180. From here, what will we get? X is equal to 180 by 5. Cancel it. You will get x is 36 degrees. Still, sum is not complete. I checked a test today where one student, I was very impressed with her performance, but she left the question up to this point. She just find x is equal to 36 and quit. Question weightage is 3 marks, she will get only 1, even she was having full knowledge. Why? Because of absent-mindedness or whatever the condition, I can't feel. But she just solve it up to x is equal to 36 and then skip the question. But see beta, you have to find the angles. You have to find the angles. What will be the first angle? Here it is 3x, yes or no? 3, what is x? 36, multiply beta, 108, yes or no? Clear? Now see, the second one is 2x, 2 into 36, what will you get? 72, and now you can check, their sum is 180, it means our answers are right. Okay, done, you can take the screenshot. Okay, now see beta, without any delay, read the statement number 3. Everybody, read the statement number 3. What is the question asked here? In question number 3, again a question based on complementary and supplementary angles. 4 times the complement of an angle is equal to its supplement. So simple beta. Number 3, let the required angle be, let the angle be x. Now what is the statement? Once you collect complement of x, that will be 90 minus x, yes or no? And supplementary of x will be 180 minus x. Done. Now see the statement. What is given? 4 times the complement is equal to its supplement. Okay, beta. 4 times the complement is equal to its supplement. What does it mean? According to condition, 4 times the complement is equal to supplement, yes or no? Done beta. Now see, multiply distributive property, 360 minus 4x, 180 minus x. What is here? Minus 4x, shift x towards left. Why? Whenever you are solving an equation in single variable, try to keep the variables on one side and constant on another side. Here constant is 180, shift 360 towards right, it will be minus 360. Now see, minus 3x is what it will be? Minus 180. Minus cancels minus, therefore x is equal to 60 degree. Why? 3 will cut 60 as 180. Okay, done. X is 60. If you want to check your answer, see, what is 90 minus x? It will be 30. Okay, and what is its complement? Its complement is 120. Now you can see, if you multiply it with 4, you will get supplement. It means 4 times the complement is equal to its supplement. Okay, condition satisfied means our sum is right. Done, take the screenshot. Now everyone, read the statement number 4. See beta, I am little bit faster during the solution of this assignment because we have completed the chapter and the questions are rewind again and again, that's why. See, question number 4. Again the same concept as it was used in second question beta. Angles of a linear pair are in the ratio 3:2. Linear pair, everyone, just think, what are linear pair angles? In the introductory lecture of chapter 6, I have given you all the information about the sides, angles, triangles, each and everything. Okay, If you remember, linear pair angles are those angles which are giving the sum of 180. Yes or no? Here 1 and 2 are linear pair. Done. Now what is the question? 3:2, let the common factor be x. Okay, ratio of angles, ratio of linear pair angles, you can write here na, angles 3:2 given, yes or no? Therefore first angle will be 3x and second will be 2x, yes or no? See beta, same question, same statement, where the angles were supplementary and in ratio 3:2 we have solved. Now it's time to solve same ratio, same concept, but the same statement is changed by just taking the word linear pair. Now 3x plus 2x is equal to 180. Why linear pair? The sum of linear pair angles is 180. Done. Now 5x is 180. From here x is equal to 36. Done. But still sum is not complete. First angle will be 3 into 36 108, and 2 into 36, that is 72. Okay. Done. Take the screenshot, because it was the same question we have revised. Question number 5. See beta, question number 5. One student was, I do not remember the name, is he made a silly mistake. I will tell you the mistake in the question. See, the exterior angles of a triangle is 108 degree. See beta, the exterior angle theorem we have discussed, yes or no? Question number 5. A triangle is given. First of all, you draw a triangle ABC. Now what is given here? Exterior angle is 108. Consider anyone, produce any side and consider any angle as an exterior angle. Okay, done. Exterior angle is 108 degree. Now the remaining, see beta, what is the given here? And the interior opposite angles are in ratio 4:5. This angle and this angle, suppose this is 1 and this is 2, these are in ratio 4:5. And what is the exterior angle theorem stating? Exterior angle is equal to the sum of this and this. Okay, one student by mistake did like this. This plus this is 180. Did not write 108, he just wrote 180. I don't know how. By mistake he replaced the digits, or he took the sum of the triangles angles as 180. Okay, it's not his or her fault, because I think it was a mistake that was made indeliberately. Now see beta, let the common factor be, whenever the question of ratio is given, close your eyes and assume the common factor. Let the common factor be x. Okay, now see, ratio given, ratio of interior opposite angles, what is this is given? 4:5, yes or no? Therefore angle 1, from the figure, right? You can use from the figure angle 1 is 4x and angle 2 will be 5x, yes or no? Angle 1 is 4x and 2 will be 5x. Now see beta, what is the condition? According to exterior angle theorem, exterior angle is sum of this and this. Okay, angle 1 plus 2 is 108 degree. Why? Exterior angle theorem applied. Okay, you have to mention the reason always. Okay, from see here beta, angle 1 is 4x, 2 is 5x, sum is 108, 9x is 108, from here x is equal to 12, yes or no? 12 9 ja 109 will cancel, 108, x is 12 degree. Yes or no? Done. Still sum is not complete. Why? Angle 1, 4 into 12, 48. Yes or no? And angle 5, 5 into 12, 60. This is 48, this is 60, and you can find this angle also by applying the angle sum property of triangles. Or you can say this is linear pair, angle 3 can be found very easily. Yes or no? It will be 72, because linear pair gives the sum 180, or you can take the sum of all these three as 180. Choice is yours. Okay, done beta. These questions are very simple. Okay, so take the screenshot. Now question number next, question number 6 beta. I am going to rough the board and you all have to read the statement. Question number 6. See, what is question number 6? Here if you see, a figure is shown. AB is parallel to CD. See beta, everyone be focused. AB is a line and CD is a line. AB and CD. What is given here? AB is parallel to CD. Okay, then see what is given. The bisectors of angle BPQ. Okay, here a transversal is also given beta. This point is P, this point is Q. And what is given here? The bisector of angle BPQ. Where is angle BPQ? BPQ. Okay? BPQ. This angle. Its bisector. And the DQP. DQP. This angle. Are meeting at O. These are the bisectors. It means, what is the actual given beta? The actual condition given is that this, if this angle is x, it will be x. Yes or no? Why? Angle bisector is given. In the same way, if we see here, bisector of this DQP is meeting the bisector of BPQ at O. This angle is y, this is also y. Bisector, bisect, bi means two, sect means dividing. Dividing the angles into two equal parts. Okay, now what is the statement? What we have to prove? We have to prove this angle is as 90 degree. We have to prove angle O is 90 degree. Okay, yes or no? Read the statement very carefully. Angle POQ, POQ, we have to prove POQ as 90 degree. Done. Should I start? Everyone see beta. Sum of cointerior angles, if you see, AB is parallel to CD and this is a PQ, is the transversal. This whole angle plus this whole angle will give you sum 180. Yes or no? See the introductory lecture, you will find each and every query if there is any. Okay, see, as AB is parallel to CD and PQ as transversal, if we observe the figure in such a manner that AB is parallel to CD and PQ is transversal, then can I say this angle, once you all see beta, I am roughing this only to make you understand very well. See, this angle plus this angle, name the angle BPQ, BPQ plus angle DQP, angle DQP is equal to 180. Y, co-interior angles, yes or no? Co-interior angles, done. Now you complete the figure. Now you complete the figure. Now see beta, what is angle BPQ? BPQ, x and x, 2x. According to figure, it's 2x. And what is DQP? It is 2y is equal to 180. And if we take the two common, x plus y will be 180. Yes or no? Yes or no? Now see, 2 cancels this, x plus y is 90, yes or no? Keep this equation in your account. It will surely help you in the solution. Okay, up to this point, I think all queries are clear. See beta, because these are co-interior angles, their sum will be 180. Therefore, 2x plus 2y is 180. From here, we got x plus y is 90. Done. Now, see beta. In triangle POQ. Now, everyone, see. In this triangle, which I am highlighting with marker. In this triangle, everyone, see. In triangle POQ, this angle plus this plus this. Suppose this is angle 1. Suppose this is angle 1. What is the angle sum property? X plus Y plus angle 1 is, this is angle 1. I have mentioned here angle 1. Okay, is 180 degree. Why 180 degree? Angle sum property of triangles. Angle sum property of triangles. Okay, now see beta, from here x plus y is 90. 90 plus angle 1 is 180, yes or no? Okay, 90 plus angle 1 is 180. From here, if we shift 90 towards right, it will be 180 minus 90, that is 90. Yes or no? From here, what we got? We got angle 1 is 90. And it was to prove that angle POQ is 90, because angle 1 is angle POQ, hence proved. Hence proved. Yes or no, beta? Done. Okay. Now you call can take the screenshot. Take the screenshot. Kar do sir, cut kar do. Now, beta, question number 7. Everyone read the statement. Question number 7. See what is given here. Here you are given a triangle ABC. Everyone pay attention. ABC. And the sides AB, BC and CA are produced. See beta, AB is produced up to X, then Y and then Z. Now what we have to prove? The question asked is, we have to prove angle CBX plus angle ACY plus angle BAZ is 360. See beta, everyone pay attention. What is asked here? Angle CBX. CBX. This is the angle 1. ACY. ACY. This is angle 2. And BAZ, BAZ, this is angle 3. In other words, you can say we have to prove for a triangle sum of external angles is 360. Sum of external angles is 360. See, consider the interior angles also, beta. Consider the interior angles. Suppose this is X, this is Y, this is Z. X plus Y plus Z. Yes or no? Now see the proof. I am directly showing you the proof. The given part and the two proof you have to write by yourself. Now see beta, can I write angle plus angle Y is 180 degree? Angle 1 plus angle Y is 180. Why? Give the reason. The reason is the angles are forming a linear pair. Done. Now, see this side. Angle 2 plus Z. This is also 180. Why? Same reason. Angle 2 plus angle Z. Z is 180. Same reason. Similarly, angle 3 plus X, this is a line, linear pair, angle 3 plus X is 180. Done. Now if we add these equations, this is first equation, second, third. If we add these, what will you get? 1 plus 2 plus 3, X, Y, Z. The sum is 540. Yes or no? Up to this point, is it clear to all? See beta, what we, how we proceed? 1 plus y 180, 2 plus z 180, 3 plus x 180. Why? Linear pair, linear pair, linear pair. When we added these three equations on the left hand side, 1, 2, 3, x, y, z, the sum was 540. Now, as we know that the sum of interior angles of a triangle is 180, we have done the angle sum property. In second video of chapter 6, I have given you the proof of this. Angle X plus angle Y plus angle Z. For a triangle, sum of interior angles is 180. Yes or no? I am going to use this value here. See, 1 plus 2 plus 3. This is 180 is equal to 540. Always mention the reason. Whatever the point, step you are taking, always mention the reason. And the reason is, why? Angle sum property of triangles. Okay? Angle sum property of triangles. Now see, 1 plus 2 plus 3 is equal to, shift 180 towards right. What will you get? 1, 2, 3 is 360. Yes or no? And it was to prove. Why? See, what is angle 1? Angle 1 is YBX. YBX plus angle 2. Angle 2 is ACY. ACY plus, and what is angle 3? Angle 3 is BAZ. BAZ. Now you can match with the statement what was asked. Okay? You all take the screenshot. Now, question number 8. Everyone read the statement. Till then I am roughing the board. Question number 8. See what is given in the question number 8. The question number 8 states that two lines are intersecting by a transversal. Everybody pay attention. What is given here? Two lines are intersected by a transversal. Okay. Such that the bisector of pair of corresponding angles are equal. Okay. Then prove that lines are parallel. See beta, suppose AB are the lines, AB, CD are the lines, and this PQ is the transversal. This PQ is the transversal. Everyone please read the statement carefully. AB and CD are not given parallel. We have to prove AB and CD are parallel. Now see, what is the statement? Half of two corresponding angles are equal. Half of any two corresponding angles are equal. You take it, you consider it. You know this is, and this. Suppose the points are M, N. Angle BMP, angle DNM. These are what? Corresponding, yes or no? What are corresponding angles? Same side, same floor. Same side and same floor. Here if we see angle BMP and angle DNM are corresponding angles. Yes or no? Done. And see beta, what is given? The second condition given is, the only condition given is bisector of these corresponding angles are equal. Suppose this is the bisector of this angle and this is the bisector of this angle and these are equal. Suppose this is x, this is x, this is x, this will be x and this is x. Indirectly, it is given that half of corresponding angles are equal. Go to the fifth chapter, the axiom by Euclid. If two quantities are equal, their halves are equal. If halves are equal, quantities are equal. Yes or no? Here we have to use that axiom. Okay? See what is given here. Half of angle BMP is equal to half of angle DNM is equal to X. Say it is given. It is given. Okay? Therefore, angle BMP is equal to 2X. X plus X, because these are equal and these are also equal. X plus X, and they, and what will be angle DNM? This is also
2X.
Yes or no? If I write from, if you see from 1 and 2, angle BMP is equal to angle DNM. Yes or no? See, beta, if corresponding angles are equal, the lines are parallel. If lines are parallel, the corresponding angles are equal. Okay, this is the property we have discussed. Therefore, we can write AB is parallel to CD. Why? Because corresponding angles are equal if and only if lines are parallel. Lines are parallel. See, beta, here the axiom given by Euclid, axiom number 5 and 6. That property is used here. If halves are equal, quantities are equal. If quantities are equal, their halves are also equal. Done. Take the screenshot, then we will go for next question. Question number 9. Done. Now everybody read the statement for question number 9. What is given here? Here the question is, okay, a figure is given here, na? First of all, I am going to draw the figure. See what is given here. AB is a line. Another line CD. And then a transversal is intersecting both the lines at P and Q respectively. Okay. And see, beta, now what is given here? By the transversal PQ, such that the bisector of angle APQ. See, where is APQ? APQ. Bisector of APQ. This angle. This is the bisector of APQ, means this angle is equal to this angle. And the second given is bisector of angle DPQ. DQP, sorry. DQP. Bisector of this angle. Okay, this is the bisector of this angle, that's why these two angles are equal. In the same way, these two angles are equal. If this is X, it will be X. If this is Y, it will be Y. Yes or no? Done. Now, prove that AB is parallel to CD. Now see, beta, what is the important thing given here is, bisectors are parallel. Bisectors are parallel. What does it mean? Now everyone see the portion that I am highlighting by the marker, different marker. See, this is parallel to this. This line is parallel to this and PQ is transversal, then X is equal to Y. See, beta, this and these lines are given like this, Q, P. These are parallel and this is treated as transversal. Definitely this angle will be this angle. Why? Alternate interior angles. Okay, now we will use the concept here. See, name it, suppose this is X and this is Y. Okay, as PX is parallel to QY, Y given. Whichever the step you are taking, always mention the reason. As PX is parallel to QY, Y it is given, and PQ as transversal. PQ as transversal, PX QY parallel, PQ transversal. Therefore, this implies that X is equal to Y. X is this angle and Y is this angle. Why? Give the reason. Alternate interior angles. Yes or no? Alternate interior angles. Now, leave it. Now I am roughing it. See beta. Only to make you understand, I am roughing it. Everyone pay attention. Now see, X is equal to Y. Therefore, 2X is equal to 2Y. Yes or no? X is equal to Y. Therefore, 2X is equal to 2Y. And if you observe this angle APQ, 2X is APQ, yes or no? I can write is angle APQ. In the same way, this 2y, 2y is PQD, 2y is angle PQD, yes or no? Done. Now, if you see, these are two lines, this is the transversal, these angles are different side, different floor, means alternate angles. Alternate angles are, we found equal, we found alternate angles equal because 2x is equal to 2y. Alternate interior angles are equal. What does it mean? Lines are parallel. Now see what I am going to write, and these are alternate interior angles for AB and CD as lines and PQ as transversal. Always remember beta, whenever you are going to deal with such kind of question, mention the lines as well as the transversal, okay? Because here in the figure, these two lines were given equal, given parallel, okay? Y X. It was the actual figure where PX was parallel to QY, PQ became the transversal, X became equal to Y. That's why Y is equal to X, 2X is equal to 2Y. APQ, PQD, alternate interior angles are equal, hence the sides, lines are parallel. Take the screenshot. Done. Now, next question. Question number 10. See what is question number 10 here. Again, a figure is given here. And what is the question? Okay. Everyone, pay attention. Question number 10 and 11 of the assignment. I have already given you the video of special theorems and last video of exercise 6.3. These two questions are discussed there, and everybody please watch those videos to understand these questions. Okay. Now question number 12. PQRS is a parallelogram and the bisectors of P and Q meet at O. Okay. Prove that angle POQ is 90 degree. Once you all draw the figure, what is given here, beta? PQRS is a parallelogram. PQRS is a parallelogram. Okay. Bisector of angle P and bisector of angle Q are meeting at O. This is equal to this, okay? And this is equal to this. Done. Now what we have to prove? Angle POQ. This one is the angle we have to prove, 90 degree. Done. This is the question. Once again, I am repeating the statement. PQRS is the parallelogram. Bisector of P and bisector of Q are meeting at O. these are bisectors, that's why these two angles are equal. In the same way, these are equal, x, x, y, y. Now what we have to prove, POQ is 90 degree. Angle 1, name it, angle 1 is equal to 90 degree, we have to prove. Now see the proof, beta. If you observe in a parallelogram, these two lines are parallel, yes or no? And these are another pair of the sides which are parallel. Now see, these are the lines and this is the transversal, then sum of these angles is 180. Why 180? Co-interior angles. See everyone, here if we observe PS and QR as lines, if we are treating PS and QR as lines and this as a transversal, what it will be? See, what will be the sum of these two angles? Yes or no? It will be 180. Done. Let me draw the figure once again to make you understand. I roughed it. Now PQRS is the parallelogram, bisector of P, bisector of Q are meeting at O. This is X, this is X, Y, Y, we have to find angle 1. Okay, now see, as SP is parallel to, SP is parallel to RQ, why opposite sides of parallelogram, opposite sides of parallelogram, and what, and in the earlier question I told you that whenever you are taking the concept of parallel lines, mention the transversal also. As SP is parallel to RQ and PQ as transversal, angle P plus angle Q is 180 degree. Why? Co-interior angles. Now see beta, what is P? 2x. What is Q? 2y. That is 180. Yes or no? Take 2 common, x plus y, 180. From here, x plus y is 90. Yes or no? Keep this in your account. It will surely help you in the next step. It will surely help you in the next. X plus y is 90 degree. X plus y is 90. Done. See beta. Now if you observe the triangle POQ. Now I am writing here, in triangle POQ. In triangle POQ, this angle plus this angle is this angle, 180, yes or no? Y, angle sum property, Y, angle sum property, X plus angle 1 plus Y is 180, angle sum property. From here, 1 plus, what is X plus Y? X plus Y is 90 degree, use it here, is equal to 180. From here, angle 1 is equal to, shift 90 towards right, 180 minus 90. That is angle 1 is 90 degree, hence proved. Why? Because angle 1 is angle POQ, POQ, and we were to prove this as 90 degree. Done beta, it was so simple. Same kind of question we have discussed earlier in the video. Okay, you all take the screenshot of the question. Now, question number 13. This is the question I have discussed in the latest video, or you can say the last video of exercise 6.3. So, everyone, please listen to me carefully. Question number 10, question number 11, and question number 13. Already I have discussed in previous video. Okay, then if you want to understand the question, go to the videos playlist and watch the video. Okay, last video of exercise 6.3. Done. Now next question. Next question is so simple, beta. So simple. Even a third class student, fourth class student can do it. See, AB is a line. AB is a line, and a ray OC is here. And our A, OC is here. This angle is A, this angle is B. Okay, and one condition is given, A minus B is 40 degree. See beta, this is the equation which is given, difference of these angles is 40 degree. And as these angles, everybody can very easily observe, these are forming a linear pair, yes or no? These are forming a linear pair, therefore A plus B is 180. A plus B is 180, yes or no? Why? Linear pair. These are the angles forming linear pair. Now two equations you have. Now see, if I add these, A minus B is equal to 40, A plus B is equal to 180. If we add these, what will you get? B cancels B. 2A is equal to 220, yes or no? From here, you will get A is 110. A is 110. Also, if we put the value of A, see, A plus B is 180, yes or no? If I use the value of A here, what the B will be? What the B will be? Everyone, P is equal to 180 minus 110, that is 70 degrees, yes or no? Okay, see beta, once again I am repeating, a figure was given where AB were forming a linear pair and here the difference was also given. This condition was given beta and this we took from the figure because these were linear pair. Then we added the equations, got A, then replaced the A with 110 in equation 1, got B. Done, take the screenshot. Okay, now question number 15. So simple question beta, within 2 minutes I am going to solve it. See, a figure is given like this where AB and CD two lines, okay, and AB is parallel to CD, good, AB is parallel to CD and POQ. P O Q. Okay, here what is angle APO? APO is 60 degrees. Done. Angle CQO. Where is C? CQO. This is 80 degree. Okay, what we have to find? Angle POQ. Sorry, reflex of angle PQ. Okay, reflex of angle POQ means once we have to find angle POQ, then we will be able to find the reflex of POQ. Okay, now POQ, this angle we have to obtain. Now see beta, this is the question same I have discussed in exercise 6.1. See, draw a line L. Always your construction, your personal construction should be in dotted, okay, dots, okay. Now see, suppose this is angle Y, this is X and Y. Now see beta, AB is parallel to CD, given, okay. Draw line L parallel to AB, automatically it will be parallel to CD, yes or no? Done. Now see beta, AB is parallel to L. AB is parallel to L and this PO is transversal. PO as transversal. What will you get? X is equal to 60 degree. Why? Alternate interior angles. Similarly, everybody see, similarly, L is parallel to CD and OQ as transversal. Okay, see, L is parallel to CD and OQ as transversal, Y will be 80. Y will be 80. Y, alternate interior angles, yes or no? Now see beta, therefore, angle POQ is equal to X plus Y, yes or no? This is the whole angle which was asked. It will be 80 plus 60, that is 140. Still the question is not over. Why? We have found POQ. We have found POQ, but reflex of POQ was asked. Therefore, the reflex angle of this will be 360 minus 140. Yes or no? 360 minus 140. Why? Reflex angle is the angle obtained by subtracting the angle from 360, or you can say the angle that gives the sum with the angle to make the sum 360. Therefore, it will be 0 to 2. Yes or no? This is the reflex of angle POQ. Okay, beta, take the screenshot. Do.